everyone. Today we want to talk about how is it that we can choose a career best. This is a decision that can be a really daunting decision. It can be one in which you spend a lot of time worrying about whether you're making the right choice and what does that right choice actually mean. So the first thing you need to remember is that a career has to be something that makes sense for you. Not what you think other people think you should be doing, not what other people think is what is the right career option for you, but one that is based on where your comfort and your strengths lie. So how do we go about doing that? The first element that we need to think about is that there has to be a great deal of exploration that takes place before you make the right career choice. And again, you don't need to have made the right career choice, just the final perfect one right away. It's all right if you want to be able to spend time exploring. So what are the elements I want to take into my exploration when I want to make this career choice? The first thing you need to think about is, think about it as a Venn diagram, all right? And in a Venn diagram, we want to be able to see how all the different circles converge and what comes up in that. In one circle, you want to be able to put down your aptitude. Your aptitude is your innate strength and ability, or in this case, where we would be able to tie it into your academics. What are the subjects you're really good at? What are the ones you really enjoy? Where are the ones you score the most? All right, so that goes into one circle. In the next circle, you want to be able to put in your interests. Co-curricular activities, extracurricular activities, areas of interest for you. Maybe it's business. Maybe you think you'd really be interested in cooking. Maybe you think you'd be really interested in doing something else related to, say, art or design. It could be the armed forces. It could be building and taking apart machines. All of those things come into your interest. So you put that in as well, in one circle. Now in the third circle, you want to really think about what kind of person you are. Who are you as an individual? Do you like doing research? Do you like to be able to organize things? Are you a little bit more creative in nature? You like to have your own space? And think about those areas. What is important to you there? I'd like to be able to work in an environment that allows me the freedom of being able to think, or the freedom to try and do new things. So those will be things you'll put in that. You then start putting things that fall into the middle where these three circles converge. And you spend time trying to be able to find out more about what are those areas that match with the subjects, the interests, and who you are as a person. A great way to be able to do that is to be able to do an assessment that allows you to be able to understand yourself on different parameters. And of course, Mindler can help you with that. Where else can you find out more? You find out more on the Mindler website when you go through the blogs and you go through the other information with it, which is related to videos or to the articles that have been posted there. You'll be able to find out a lot more. You spend time speaking to professionals. Professionals who are in these areas of interest where you are thinking about wanting to work. Ask them, what's their job like? What do they love about their work? What do they not like about it? What are the things they wish they'd done differently? What are the subjects they studied? And what are the skill sets that are required in order to be able to do this work? And see how those match up with who you are and what you like doing as well. The more time you spend getting to know yourself and knowing about what you enjoy and what you like, the easier it becomes for you to be able to understand what are the careers that may make sense for you. So remember, you need to be able to create a Venn diagram with your aptitude, your interests, and who you are as a person. Where are these three converging and what are the different career options that come out through that? And any assessment that you do will always help you be able to understand yourself better. So think about how you want to be able to explore. Make this choice. It has to be for you. What is the best fit for you? Where you are most comfortable. You're going to be spending time doing this, so it's a good idea for you to be happy and not just worry about what everybody else is going to think. I hope this helps. Thank you so much.